As the demand for faster and more efficient Wi-Fi continues to soar this year, the question arises, what is the best router for 2023? As I search online, I found this Huawei Wi-Fi AX3 dual core. Sleek and contemporary in its white aesthetic, this router isn't just about good looks. Measuring 225mm by 159.2mm by 39.7mm and weighing just around 387 grams, this lightweight device is more than what meets the eye. Powered by the latest Wi-Fi 6 technology, the AX3 boasts substantial improvements over its predecessor, Wi-Fi 5, answering the call for faster and more reliable internet. Speaking of speed, get ready to experience wireless speeds of up to 2,976 megabits per second. To break it down, that's 574 megabits per second on the 2.4 GHz band and a whopping 2,402 megabits per second on the 5 GHz band. Under the hood, the GigaHome dual-core 1.2 GHz CPU ensures that your devices stay connected and function at peak performance. Connectivity is a breeze with 110/100s, 1,000 megabits per second Ethernet port for WAN and three similar ports for LAN. Management is at your fingertips with the Huawei AI Life app, where controlling your Wi-Fi settings has never been easier. Plus, with features like guest Wi-Fi, parental control, and device speed limiting, the AX3 has got you covered. But it's not just about speed and control. The AX3 places paramount importance on security. With anti-brute force algorithms, WPA3, firewall, and more, it's your digital fortress. So, is the Huawei Wi-Fi AX3 dual core the best router for 2023? The specs speak for themselves. Now, I will show you how to configure this router. You need to connect the Huawei AX3 router to the modem. If not connected, an error will appear when you access the Huawei AX3 management page. Make sure that the WAN port is properly connected to the internet. Please ensure that the network cable is in good condition and firmly plugged in, and the modem is powered on. I've already connected my router to this computer using Wi-Fi. By the way, there is no password needed when you first access or configure this modem. Once connected, a browser will automatically open and redirect you to 192.168.3.1, which is the router's management page. Just click Agree to the End User License Agreement, then click Let's Get Started to proceed. Wait for a few seconds while the device connects to the internet. Let us set the Wi-Fi name and password, change Wi-Fi network name to Google Map, assign Wi-Fi network password, assign admin password, and confirm admin password to ensure it's correct. We also have an option to backup Wi-Fi 5, when enabled, this ensures that certain devices can't discover the Wi-Fi 6 networks can still connect to the internet. I will just enable this. I will enable the retain key settings. When reconfiguring the router, the network configuration will be automatically filled in for you. Sounds great. In the network mode, I will choose IPv4 and IPv6. Just make sure your internet service provider has enabled IPv6. In my case, I don't know if IPv6 is enabled by my ISP. Just click Next. On my phone, I have the option to install the AI Life app to manage my devices and everyone's internet access. There is also an option to enable guest Wi-Fi easily for a safe network environment. Let's wait while the Wi-Fi is restarting. We need to reconnect our devices to this new Wi-Fi network and enter the updated password. If you are connected using an Ethernet cable, you are automatically connected to the network, and there's no need to enter the new password. Now, let's log in using the admin password to modify the router settings. The Home tab shows the number of devices connected, the 4G and 5G connection status, and the shutdown icon. The Connect to the Internet tab shows that the WAN port is connected, and there's no need to change or configure here. My Wi-Fi tab shows the Wi-Fi network name and password. The Manage Device tab shows the connected devices. I have my desktop computer connected here, and there is an option to limit internet speed. Under the More Functions tab, you'll find About Router, which shows the EMUI router version and Manage Updates, where you can update your router software versions to improve the user experience and discover new functions. Just click New Versions and one-click Update, then wait while updating. It's essential to wait and not disconnect the power supply during the update to avoid damaging your router. Once it's restarted, sign in using the admin password again. In the last part of this video, I have conducted here various speed tests and created different scenarios. During the actual test, I just used one Ethernet cable that is almost 100 meters in length and is far from the main internet service provider. In each test, I connected the router to the modem. Here are the speed test results.
I've seen a lot of change, been through a lot of pain. Some things are not the same as they were a year ago. But all will be okay, I move on each and every day. The past is where it stays, way back a year ago. I've changed for the better this time. I thought I would never be fine. I strive just to say I'm alright. And for the first time in a long time, I'm alright.